Hey guys and gals, so today I'm going to be making this table for my drill press. And of course, here in the UK, they call it a pillar drill. Now, if you didn't know the story behind this drill press, this was actually donated to me by a local gentleman whose, where he works, they were throwing it away. So he managed to salvage it for me. And although it doesn't look the greatest, it works just fine and I couldn't be happier. Now, as you know, I use this drill press all the time, and despite that, I've never actually got round to building a table for it. Now, if you're someone who never really uses a fence while at the drill press, just having a table which provides more support than the little thing which they give you, and having a replaceable insert, is really useful. Now, having a fence, I don't use a fence all that often, but having it here when you need it couldn't be better. I actually drew this up in Google SketchUp before I built it, so if you're looking to build your own drill press table, then there's some plans available for you to download for free at my website, and the link for that will be in the description. So here's the material which I'm going to be using for the table, and it's just some 18mm MDF which I've cut to 500mm by 350mm. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut two slots into the MDF, which will allow me to attach the fence on using some coach bolts. Now, of course, you could just set in two T-tracks, which you can buy. I'm not a huge fan of those. They're a little bit expensive, but the main reason is that you get the chips stuck in the T-tracks, and of course you can just usually clean those out, but to save that, I'm just going to cut two little slots in it over here at the router table. So I've attached a 6mm router bit to the table to match the size of the coach bolt which I'm using, and I've also marked two positions where I can start and stop here on the fence, and so that way when I pass the MDF across the router bit, because of course I won't be able to see the router bit, I can start at this point, move it through the bit and stop here. And it doesn't really matter if I go slightly past these points, they're just there for reference really. And with the first slot cut, I can flip the board end to end, and using the same setup as before, cut the second. Now over at the drill press, I'm drilling a 16mm hole at the back of each slot, and this is going to allow me to connect the fence to the table a lot quicker. With those holes drilled, I will be able to drop the fence in and tighten it up from the back without having to undo any bolts to get it in, so that makes life a little bit easier. So now I've marked out for a slot for an insert which I'll be able to stick in here, and I've actually made that off center so that I will be able to sort of rotate the insert around when it gets a lot of holes in, and that way each insert lasts a bit longer. The first thing I've done is drilled a hole in each corner, and that will mean that dust doesn't sort of get caught in those corners, because that can be a real problem when that happens. So now I'm just going to go ahead and use a jigsaw, and I'll cut out this center portion here which I need to remove. I'm setting the router to make a 12mm cut so I can make the insert out of some standard half-inch plywood. And using the fence, I route a small lip for that insert. And to finish that off, I square off the corner with a chisel. Right, there we go. Now, just to make that a little bit easier to get out when I need to, I'm just going to drill a small hole here at the front using a Forstner bit. So the final thing which I need to do to the table is to round off the corners over here at the bandsaw. And I'm also making a cutout to allow some room for the pillar of the drill. And of course, you could just do this with a jigsaw. Right, so now I can attach the table to the table of the drill press itself. And to do that, I'm actually just going to use four bolts. I did think about having some sort of a clamping system underneath to just hold it on there temporarily. But in the end, I decided that I wasn't really going to be removing this at all. So I'm just going to use four bolts to attach it. And I've actually gone ahead and already tightened up three of the four bolts. And so I'm just going to attach the last one now. So I drilled the holes and counterpoured for the heads of the bolts so that they sit below the surface of the table. And now I can just tighten that down. Right, so now I can go ahead and make the fence for the table. So to make the fence, I've got these two strips of MDF which I ripped to 60 millimeters wide. Now this is not going to make the tallest fence in the world, but to be honest, most of the time you don't really need a tall fence. And of course, if you do need a taller fence, you can just clamp on an extra sort of extension onto here. Now I do actually want a T-track on the fence so that I can attach a stop block where I want to on the fence nice and easily. Now to do that, I've just made a series of passes over at the table saw to cut out this dado. Now when I later on stick this hardboard face, and of course it could be plywood, I'll be able to cut another slot. And that'll create a nice T-track which I can just sit a coach bolt in, to be honest. And so that I can hook up a shot vac, I've also made this little cutout at the front of the fence. Now the first thing that I'm gonna do is to glue and screw these two pieces together. And you want to make sure that that is nice and square. But if it isn't quite there, you can always take a pass or two over at the jointer once the glue's dried. And now I'm just gluing the hardboard onto the front. And once that had dried, I could use the table saw once again to cut a groove and form the T-track. Having done that, I used the bandsaw to cut a relief in the back of the fence this time, and once again it's to leave room for the drill press's pillar. Then over at the router table I cut a small chamfer at the bottom of the fence, and this will prevent chips from skewing the registration up against the fence. And I also do the same around this small dust extraction port which I cut. So I'm just finishing off the fence by attaching a few little support blocks. And to these two center brackets, I'm also attaching this piece of plywood, which I'll be able to hook my shop vac up with. Now the final thing I've done to the fence is to drill two holes into it, which I've stick these two coach bolts into. And now if I stick it into the holes at the back, I can slide the fence forward to where I need it, and I can lock down those two knobs there. And I've also made this little stop block out of a couple of scraps of wood. And that simply slots into that T-track we made, and I can lock that down like that. Right, so there we go. That's how to build a table for your drill press. Now this is quite a simple one really, but I am actually very glad that I got round to building it. Now once again, if you're looking to build your own drill press table, be sure to head over to my website and take a look at the plans for that. You will of course need to have Google SketchUp downloaded onto your computer before you can open them up. But once you've done that, you can take a look around the entire model and see all the dimensions I've done for this. But of course, go ahead and make any adaptations which you want to this table to make the table which best suits your needs. Right, thanks for watching everybody. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.